The prophet you don't recognize cannot listen. When you're telling me your problem, I'm not seeing you. I am the big God who is bigger than that problem.
Help me look at somebody by your right hand side. Look into his or her eyes. Say to him, anytime there's a delay in miracles, God sends a prophet.
Grace has found me just as I am. Empty hand above
the love. Show me your faith and I will show you your miracle.
On Tuesday coming, that boy that quarreled with you is setting you up again, and their plan is to stab you with bottle on your head. When that happens on Tuesday, don't respond.
We're singing Majesty.
The Bible says, if the foundation is shaken, what will the righteous do? I came to somebody this afternoon with a message. A message of hope. A message of faith. Just to let you know that problems may last, but they are not everlasting.
Instructions from God can come in different ways. Amen. One of my daughters came to me and said that I've been having this painful menstruation for some time now. That it, honestly speaking, is so bad. Let me be honest. I said, be honest. She said, since I was born, I grew up, I saw my menses, and it's been so painful. I said, how old are you? She said, 21. I said, go raise a seed of 21,000 naira. Dump it on the altar. Light the altar for 2 hours. Get up and go home. She said, that's it. You won't pray for me. Next person, she carried her bag and ran out of my office. And she left. 2 days later, I used to come early in the morning to pray on this altar. I saw someone lying by the altar. And I went, peeped, it was her. I left. After praying, I left. 2 days later, she sent me a text. She said, Daddy, do you know I saw my period without knowing it was my period? So what happened? I don't know what happened, but I didn't know. I didn't even remember. It has finished and there was no single pain. One instruction from your prophet solves your problem. Say, go and borrow vessels. Go. There were four of them, if you remember, in one of our services in August, they were in church when our altar, before August, when our altar used to be there. And I said, someone here, you're suffering from pile. About four ladies came out. And a young man. And I said, go sit on my seat. And she went and sat on my seat. Others just sat and left. Others just sat and left. And there was this lady that sat on my chair and she refused to go. And I said to them, please lock up the church. After the pastor's meeting, it was evening, about some minutes to six. And I saw this person still sitting there and said, if I go now, the security people will come and send you out of the church. I said, pastor, beg them. I know what I'm looking for. Beg them to give me the next 1 hour. She removed her suit and she was sitting down on my chair. She refused to go. She sat down there. 2 Sundays later, which was PhD service, and she was one of the people that lined up to testify. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. This is a pile I have suffered. I have got operation for 2 good times and it grew again. They said this one is a 3rd degree. Daddy asked us to sit on his chair 2 weeks ago. I sat on that chair. Braden, I am here to tell you that I was going to the toilet and it fell off and today it's no longer there. Praise the Lord. I remember picking up the microphone and said, there were 4 of you. Where are the 3? 4 persons were given instruction. 1 person got the testimony. Why? Instruction makes for construction. Instruction. And the man of God said, go borrow vessels. She didn't argue. She didn't do mathematics in her brain. She said, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. She zoomed out. And when I borrowed vessels, the man of God said, shut the door. Hallelujah. The oil of God in your life can only flow in its fullness when you understand the ministry of separation, the ministry of retreats, the ministry of revival. There are some things that God will not do in your life until you separate yourself from some people. Why did the man of God say, lock yourself up? Don't allow anybody, even when they knock, don't open your door. Why? When God wants to deal with you, he deals with you on individual basis, one-on-one. There are some things you need to cut off, some exuberance, some activities you need to yank off your life so that God can flow into you. There are certain things you need to shift from you. Places you are not supposed to be there. Put off your radio. Put off your television. Let it expire. Let your BEP or whatever, BM, expire. Let it go. Stop pinging for 2 days. No internet for the next 3 days. Kneel down, face down, look for your God. There are certain miracles that will never happen until you are alone with God. Go search the scriptures. All the people that encountered God, they were all alone with God. Either they were in the mountain with God or they were in the bush with God. Moses never encountered God until he was alone in the bush. Daniel never encountered God until he was alone in the lion's den. Listen, there are times when you need to separate yourself so you can have quality impartation from the Holy Spirit. That's why the Lord said, shut the door. Shut the door. Sometimes on a purpose, I allow my credit to finish. I run everything to run off. No communication. I shut up. I just want to be with the Lord. Sometimes my phone can ring. And yesterday I had more than, how many missed calls? 200 something missed calls. Pick it for what? I had time with the Holy Spirit. Don't need to call anybody. Don't need to pick anybody's call. Sit down at his feet. Let him pour his grace upon you. 1 minute with God is equal 100 years with men. 1 minute with God. I can treasure 1 minute with God than treasure 100 years with men. 1 minute with God. Help me tell your neighbor, say, 1 minute with God is all you need to have a quality destiny. Somebody say amen. And she shut the door. The Bible said, and when she shut the door, the oil started flowing. The oil started flowing. Obedience to instruction is what activates the miracle. Hello. Hello. Obedience to what? Instruction is what? What? What activates your miracle? Obedience to instruction. And the woman shut the door. She didn't argue. She took one bottle of oil. Imagine in your mind how she took one bottle of oil pouring in a 50 jerry can. 50 liter jerry can. Does it make sense? It doesn't make sense. But she didn't argue. Simple obedience. She shut the door and started pouring. If you want a miracle, obey the man of God. Amen. And he said to him, dip yourself 7 times in Jordan. Muddy river. And the leprosy will fly away. The man started reasoning. Is it possible? He nearly missed his miracle. But when the house help came and said, sir, it doesn't mean anything. Dip yourself. He dipped himself 7 times. What happened? The Bible said he was cleansed. He gave another instruction. He said, these are 6 water pots. Fill them with water. And they filled the water pots with water. Before they turned their back, he said, draw the water again. Oh, this man, you're disturbing us. They never said that. They drew the water back and it turned to wine. In obedience to instruction activates the miracle. Obedience to instruction of the prophet does what? Activates the miracle. Lift up your hands. Say, I will obey the word of the prophets. Oh, come on. I can't hear you. Say it louder. Oh, you can do better than that. Say it louder. Oh, say it louder. But this is what touched me. I said this and I begin to run up. The Bible said, and she was pouring, and they were bringing, she was pouring, and they were bringing, she was pouring. But the moment she stopped pouring, the oil stopped flowing. The oil is dead. The moment she stopped pouring, the oil stopped. Any day you stop giving, you stop receiving. The moment she stopped pouring, the Bible said that the provision did not cease. The principle is is very simple. Give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, press down, shake it together and running over. When you don't give, what happens to you? It stays. No more. The worst thing that happened to a man is to stop giving. The day you stop giving, you start dying. Giving is living. Giving is living. The woman said, I just have a cup of flour to bake some cake. When I eat it, I will die with my son. But when she gave, she lived. Assuming she didn't give, she would have died. So giving is living. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but what? Have a giving is living. Many people are managing their life because they are not givers. See those people that when they talk all about giving and they are murmuring, they can't prosper. And I'm being led to give you that. And as I'm giving that, another one is coming. You can listen to me. If the day you close your door is the day you stop giving. That's the truth. That's the truth. And the woman stopped pouring. And the oil ceased. I never ask you to stop. Listen to me. This is the good news. Those of them that were waiting to laugh at her, the Lord changed her story. There is no way men will insult you because you will have a result that will eliminate insult in your life. Did you hear what I just said? There is no way men will insult you because you will have what? A result that will eliminate what? Insult in your life. That's what God does. He gives every man results. After this service, God will give you your results. And it will eliminate insult in your life. I say your story will change. What was the story? It was everywhere that woman's husband was dead. And her children are going to become slaves. But after encounter with the prophet, the story changed. What was the story? That woman that used to owe, she is now one of the richest women in our town. Come and see. Why? Because Elijah said, sell all your oil and pay your debt. The remaining can lead you everlasting. She became a martyr. She hammered because the prophet spoke. Every one of you struggling with your finances, if I be a prophet of God unto your life, I declare supernatural supply. I declare supernatural supply. Those who are waiting to laugh at you, my God will close their mouth forever. Those who are waiting to shit at you, they will turn and become your stepping stone. Lift up your hand and shout that amen 7 times. Number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, number 7. I serve a living God. He can turn around your story any given time. The same God that turned around the story of this woman is available here this morning to turn around somebody's story. He turned my story when I was struggling as a young pastor, trekking the streets of Owerri without having anything. Today he turned my story. That same God can turn your story. I am no longer a beggar. I am a giver, distributing to many by the mercies of this same God. And I read something about him, that this same God is the same yesterday. He is the same today, and he will remain the same forever. He can't come to your situation and change. He is still the great provider. David said, I have looked up to the hills. From where cometh my help? He said, my help cometh from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Your friends may fail you. Your parents may desert you. But there is only one man who cannot fail. A songwriter wrote a song concerning him. He said, on Christ, the solid rock I stand. By the axle, he said, because all other ground, they are sinking sand. I stand on this solid rock. He has never failed anybody. He cannot fail you.
In the morning you stand on him, in the noon you stand on him, in the night you stand on him. He will never fail. He has never failed. God is faithful, the safeguard of your soul. He prepared a table before you in the presence of your enemy. He anoints your head with oil and your cup runs over. I come to preach him to you. The man that can close the mouth of the lions, he is your God. The man that can walk upon the waters, he is your God. It is God El Shaddai. He will supply your needs. He will not allow you to be put to shame. He will open your door. When the enemy thought he has closed your door, your God will open 7 other doors. I see him opening your door for you. You will never fail. You will never fail. Rise to your feet and give him glory in the house. Answer of days. Give him praise for supernatural supply. Give him praise. Somebody's about to testify. Open your mouth and pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Holy Ghost. He will supply all your needs according to his riches in glory. Open your mouth and pray in the Holy Ghost. He will supply your needs according to his riches in glory. Since I was born, now I am getting old, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor their seed begging bread. God cannot fail. Hey, give him praise in the house for supernatural supply. Glory to God in the highest. I feel like dancing. I feel like praising the Lord. My God cannot fail. He will not fail that woman. He will never fail me. No shame will come to you. Open your mouth and glorify him. In nothing will you be ashamed. In house rent, you will not be ashamed. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In your health, you will not be ashamed. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I feel like praising God. I feel like giving him praise. Somebody glorify his name. Hallelujah. Glory to God in the highest. Hallelujah. God, you are graceful. Glorify his holy name. Glorify his holy name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Can I minister to you, please? Please come. Can I minister to you, please? Can I minister to you? Two of you, the young man like this, and two. Can I minister to you? Thank you, Holy Spirit. While I was praying, this just now, at the end of the message, the other young man, can I minister to you too? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Can I minister to you, please? Yes, please. Hallelujah. The Lord says, I should tell you that the enemies that have ganged up to take away your father's inheritance from you and from your brothers, that he will put them to shame. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? That's a land they want to take away from you. Is that correct? How many plots of land is that?
10 plots of land.
Where are you from, sir?
I'm from Amakoheorato.
Amakoheorato, where? The Lord says, I should tell you, 48 days from now, those who went and witnessed against your family will turn around and begin to say the truth for your family. Because I see this case in the court already. They are already dragging it. It's in the court. You are in the court already. God is going to give you victory. The moment the court calls off the strike, your victory process will begin. Pray for 3 days. Tell your family members. Fast and pray for 3 days. 6 to 1. Fast. It's only prayer that will disarm these people. God is on your side. Listen to me. You have to pray about your marriage. Somebody don't need to approve you before you get married. Anywhere that they are waiting to approve you, it's not God's will. You are who you are by the mercies of God. Pray again. Listen to me. Listen, for these ladies that go for sampling, I want my father, my uncle, my mother to approve you before I marry. It's not marriage, yo. It's not marriage. Somebody must marry you for who you are.
pray against anything sampling, that God will send his will direct in your life. Are you listening to what I'm saying now? Because I see a breakthrough like this in your life. I see a breakthrough like this. I see a breakthrough. I see a breakthrough. God is going to make you queen. Queen of a home. Queen. That you sit down, you don't suffer, you don't struggle for anything. You are walking into wealth. Because in the month of March, 30th, a miracle will begin in your life. I see the Lord opening the door for you, brother. I see the door opening for you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. I see it in September 19th. A miracle is going to be happening in your life. Do you know September 19th? Do you do anything on September 19th? It's your birthday. I see God doing a miracle. Because you are sitting down in this hall. It was a lecture hall, and you were reading. One of the nights you were reading. Thank you, Jesus. Did you go to Esut?
That was where I did my first degree.
That's where you did your first degree. You are sitting down in that lecture hall, and in the night, you started having a visitation, and you closed your book. I started praying. That was where God sent you. It was towards your final year exam. God told you that he will make you a name amongst your people. God says, I should remind you, between now and 19th, a miracle will take place in your life that will close the mouth of your villagers. That's what the Lord is telling me. That's what the Lord is telling me about you. Sir, I see a door opening for you. I see a door, because I see you're carrying this briefcase at the airport. And I said, what is happening? The Lord said to me, I'm taking him to Europe because I want to establish his life there. What's your name, sir? Put the microphone in your mouth. Caleb, what do you do, sir? You're a student of where? IMSU, what year? Finance. Are you doing anything about going for scholarship abroad? Do you want to do any master's program? You have it in mind, but you've not started. Plan it, because a door has opened for you in Europe for a master's program. Stretch out your hand towards these people. Let's begin to pray out their miracles. Maria Gaba Sobra Lagadaba Hashi Brabash. Holy Ghost anointing. Holy Ghost anointing, Holy Ghost anointing, Holy Ghost anointing, Holy Ghost anointing, Rarabah Sadalarabah, Holy Ghost anointing, Libra Kadaru Sharanabah. Lift up your hands wherever you are. I release anointing all over your lives. I release anointing of the Holy Ghost all over you, all over you, all over you, all over you. Give me the oil, give me the oil. Anoint anointing, anointing of the Holy Ghost. All over your life, all over your life. Anointing of the Holy Ghost. 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 Make you great. Anointing of the Holy Ghost. Make you great. Anointing of the Holy Ghost. Make you great. Establish you and cause his grace to rest upon you. Father, look at these hands. Stretch out your hands, everybody. Lift it up, lift it up, lift it up. Father, look at these hands. I can't touch them, but I stretch forth my hands. Let there be supernatural supply in their lives. Let there be supernatural supply in their lives. Let there be supernatural supply in their lives. In the name of Jesus Christ. Your point of shame will become your point of victory. Your point of shame will become your point of victory. Your point of shame will become your point of victory. This week you will have a testimony. God will shut up the mouth of your enemies with give abos ka inkutabalia. I said, my God will shut up the mouth of your enemies. He will give you financial surprises. Financial favor is your portion. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Listen.
Thank you so much for watching. I'm sure you have been truly blessed. To share your praise report or prayer request, SMS Pastor Larry on the number showing on your screen, or you can email us at larrymichelle123@gmail.com. God bless.